So now, according to the video, we just dip this. As soon as I saw this video, I was like, let me put my safety glasses on because we're about to do some science experiments today. Like, this is about to get real. We got these, we got fire, there you go, and we got peanut butter. So we're about to turn this peanut butter or this coal into a freaking crystal. This is why I failed chemistry. So this is charcoal that you use basically for barbecue. I mean, I bought a lot of it because in case we need many tries. So according to the video, we're gonna set this on fire and then while it's still burning hot, we're gonna dip it into the peanut butter and then immediately freeze it. So I think timing is kind of important here. I also switched off my fire alarm, which I don't know if that's brilliant or... So here we've got our charcoal. So this is what we're turning into, like a freaking rock or like, I don't know what you call it. I don't want to set my kitchen on fire, but I do want this to work. Why is nothing coming out? Why am I terrified of this? Oh my god. I want to touch it, but I don't know if these things are gonna melt. Are these fireproof? This, it doesn't really get hotter than this. Like, holy schnitzel. Should we turn it on the other side? I feel like... Okay, so I'm gonna prepare the ice because I think this is actually working. So we got the peanut butter here. Now I'm gonna fill this up with ice while just the last tiny little bits of the coal are burning. So far, so good. So here we've got a big bowl of ice and this is just, I think, finishing up. Let me make sure there's nothing else to burn. As you can see, this is as hot as it gets and I'm also pretty sure I've cleared my house of any demons or ghosts. So now, according to the video, we just dip this. This is so freaking cool. Okay, so we're gonna make sure it's well coated. Okay, this is kind of more difficult to coat than it seemed on the video. Okay, I think this is good. So the coal is somewhere in here and now we're just going to drop it on the ice. As you can see, this is our charcoal. It's well coated. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna top it with some more extra ice because I feel like that's what they've done in the videos. But of course, I'm not gonna make you guys wait for another video to see the result. This has actually been in there for longer than 24 hours, so if this works, this will work with this one that I prepared. It literally, like, all the ice comes off, but do you see that? It's so stuck in there. So what they did on the video is they just started peeling off the peanut butter, and then it was almost like a layer of coal on the outside. So I'm trying to get past this layer of coal. Okay, so I literally just sliced a whole chunk of this and it's still freaking charcoal. Oh my god, it broke. Okay, this is the moment of truth. Let's see if this truly became a crystal. Are you kidding me? I expect nothing and I'm still disappointed. Like, I set a fire in my kitchen for this? I hate all these stupid, like, viral, like, science hacks. I've got no words to express the way I'm feeling because I've truly been invested in this specific hack. I mean, we've got more coming up in this video, but I've been invested in this one for the last like week. Like, I really thought I was gonna get a beautiful crystal and literally all I've got is a mess. to clean up. So let's move on to the next science experiment and just hope that something at least works, because I need it. My reaction when I saw this video was, I would like to see it.
I would like to see it.
I literally would like to see it. This is one of those that, I mean, if this actually works, like, how have I never heard of this before? But I mean, who am I to say whether stuff works or not? Because I have been wrong before. So what I'm gonna do is just start with the ice. This video is using a lot of ice so far. So this is the bottle of water. I mean, it's kind of cold-ish, but not really cold. Like, it's definitely not even close to like freezing. It's like very much liquid. So we're gonna put that with the ice. And now we're gonna add the salt on top of it. So we're gonna top it up with more ice, because that is literally what they've done in the video. I mean, I wanna believe, like, I don't think anyone would like use special effects to like lie to people. That's psychopathic. I mean, not trying to expose this account who came up with the video. So now we're gonna top it all up with the salt. My cholesterol says thank you. I mean, we did a pretty good job of covering most of it. I mean, this part is not fully covered, but I don't know how else to do it. Let's cover it in salt, just in case. Hey Siri, set up a timer for 5 minutes.
5 minutes, counting down.
Okay guys, so it's been officially 5 minutes. It's actually been a little bit longer, but hopefully that's fine. Okay, I don't want to move it too much yet. Okay, and now the moment of truth. Hello? Okay, maybe it's gonna happen now. Are you kidding me? Are you for real? Like, I'm being 100% serious when I say this, but I'm pretty sure this is warmer than it was before. Like, it's not even close to freezing. It's just like room temperature. This is another one that kind of sounds insane and like just stupid, and why would you do it? So honestly, perfect for my video. So what they did in the video is they pour some milk into the Coca Cola, and I know that sounds gross, but once you shake it, the milk sort of like weighs down and it sort of removes all the color from it all the way to the bottom. So what you're left with is literally see-through Coca Cola. So I think, oh no, they didn't say anything about this happening. Oh my god, I think it's actually working. Look, it's so much darker in the bottom. Oh my god, I'm so glad you guys can see it on camera. Okay, let's add more milk. I don't know if you can see on camera, but like, look at the top. It's like really, really weird. Wait, I probably should move it. But I mean, we've already really ruined everything else. So it should be fine. Let's shake it really well. And now, are we supposed to, wait, maybe we need to keep it like that. Wait, let me watch the video really quickly. In the video, they sort of just keep it like that. So let's keep it tight. I am truly speechless. I mean, everything is going wrong in this video. Like, this has been sitting here for like 15 minutes and it's barely moving. Like, I don't see this actually going anywhere. I'm gonna keep it real. I don't think this is gonna happen. I'm curious if this is gonna taste nice. Also me after I drink this. Oh, I've got no patience. I just had to do it. I actually don't think you said anything about not drinking this, right? Like, it can't be bad for you, right? It's like chocolate milk, but improved, so. Even though there is science behind it, I feel like this next one is actually very realistic that like people would actually use it. And I think like this is one of those that grandmas kind of know about. But basically here we've got some tomatoes. I mean, as you can see, they're not like perfectly red. I mean, I'm gonna do a close-up so we can compare whether this actually works or not. So this would probably take like, I would say like maybe 1 to 2 days to like this to become like bright red, I guess. So what we're gonna do is we've got a banana that is literally close to being rotten. I mean, can you believe they sell this at the supermarket? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put it in this bag, and then we're gonna throw the banana in there, and I'm gonna make sure that it's really tight, like there's nothing else messing up with our experiment. Like, we're very scientific today. Oh shoot. Oh my god. This is a lot darker than before. Okay, I'm so glad I've got the before and after photos. And I hope I'm right, because sometimes when I watch it back, I mean, I could be wrong, obviously, but like, I really feel like this makes a huge difference. Call me an idiot, but I actually had no idea that when you buy like an apple from the supermarket, that it's actually covered in wax. Like, that is really, really strange that they would cover it with something that we don't even know that we're eating. I mean, I'm sure a lot of you guys already knew this, but a lot of you probably have no clue that the reason why apples are so shiny, like at the supermarket, it's because they're covered in wax. So I guess if we pour some hot water on top of this, the wax is going to come off, like it basically washes off. Okay. Okay, I can't really see what's happening. It seems like it's getting kind of dark. That's really weird. Oh, how do I not even know how to work with a freaking apple like a normal individual? Like, I don't know if you guys can see that, but like, isn't that so weird? I think this is like the spot where the wax didn't come off. So this is like, this is what you buy at the supermarket. Look how shiny it looks. And this is like the real deal. It almost looks like a freaking peach because it's so like matte. That is a real apple. Wow, I don't think I've ever seen one before. So here we've got some pancake mix. I mean, this is technically supposed to be made in here, but we're gonna go fancy for this video. And we've also got some carbonated water. Let's just go ahead and give it a try. I mean, I'm trusting this is gonna work, so I'm gonna use all of it. So if you're feeling fancy, I mean, you could definitely, maybe you can make it from scratch, but this is good enough for me. So do you see like all these bubbles? Like, the thing is, when you start mixing it, isn't that gonna like remove all the bubbles? I'm kind of concerned about like flavor as well, because I don't know if it's just me, but like carbonated water kind of tastes like metallic to me. Okay, let's cook this up and see if it works as well as it does in the video. Like, you can see all the tiny little bubbles. So far, it's kind of promising, I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna make sure this is very much non-stick, because especially if it's gonna be like, I'm not gonna say undercooked, but like in the video it seemed kind of undercooked. So it doesn't fall apart when we try to remove it. So let's turn up the heat. Let's just see what happens. Oh. Okay, so I just wanna give you a close up of the pancake. And I mean, it doesn't seem too bad. Okay, I'm gonna try still, because otherwise it's going to overcook. Okay. Okay, that's not bad. And it's probably kind of raw in the middle, so Love that for me. Okay, so we already know that the look isn't it, but maybe, and just maybe, this will be so light and fluffy that it will make up for the fact that it does look kind of horrifying. It's weirdly soft in the center and kind of crispy on the outside, which I wasn't expecting, but it's kind of good. Like, it's a good pancake. Like, I kind of like the doughiness of it, which might be a personal taste. I'm actually very excited for this next one, and I know it seems like pretty simple, but I've always kind of liked that in science, the fact that like there's like secrets like hidden in things like DNA, for example. If this works right, like we'll literally see this structure of like, it kind of looks like a honeycomb, like you'll see like the whole like honey structure. One of the few requirements is that you use real honey, and my mom actually sent me this honey from Portugal, so I'm pretty sure this is as real as it gets. Like, this probably came like directly from like a factory. Like, so this better not disappoint. So we're gonna pour that in the bottom. So we're gonna move quickly and add the water on top. And now I guess we just shake it. Oh, shoot, there's water everywhere. I mean, something is happening. Oh my God, I can kind of see it. Oh my God, I can see it. Can you guys see it? When it's moving, you can kind of see it. Oh, I hope like you guys can see that as well. That's really cool. It's not picking up on camera, which is really frustrating, because I'm like making a mess here, but wow, love that for me. Is it safe to say that we're never gonna look at food and science the same way? Not quite. I mean, I'm happy that some of these actually worked and this video wasn't a huge failure, but I'm very disappointed that the charcoal becoming a freaking diamond, like, that didn't work, because that was the reason why I wanted to make this video, so I'm apologizing in advance. But still, if you guys enjoyed this video, it would mean the world to me if you could give it a like. I've honestly cleaned up my kitchen so many times in between that alone has taken me like, I would say like 4 hours of cleaning. So do let me know if you guys want to watch a part two for this, because that was weirdly fun. I mean, I feel like maybe next time I need to do more research, and maybe I should get someone who actually understands about science in here. That would probably help. I hope you had fun, and if you did, please don't forget to subscribe and switch my notifications on. All you have to do is tap that little bell, and please only subscribe if you like my videos. If you don't like my videos, there is no pressure, like, it's totally fine. So that's about it. I love you guys, and I will see you guys in 2 days, I think. Bye bye.